When it comes to the church, do you think bigger is better? Hey everyone, and welcome back to Breakfast at Tracy's. We are entering the kingdom, taking a look around at much of what God has to say about our future with Him. Thank you to all of you who make comments and share these videos with others. We want as many people to be strengthened, encouraged, and comforted in their faith as possible. I was listening to a podcast recently and the speaker was talking about the problem with mega churches. Hey, there's lots of good things about bigger churches, she admitted, but she questioned the spiritual health of bigger churches. Often mega churches are built on the personality of a single leader. A great speaker can certainly be used by God to do tremendous things, and history has shown that. But sometimes a speaker can be more interested in putting people in seats than in explaining the gospel message itself. Sometimes messages can begin to sound more like motivational speeches rather than God's comforting and confronting revelation. Today, many people in Christian culture have their favorite speakers. This one will like Joel Osteen. This one will like John MacArthur. This one will like Tim Keller or Joyce Myers or Melissa Doherty. Today, people will often skip worship altogether if they find out that their favorite speaker isn't speaking, which is a real indictment of why we worship in the first place. The same thing was happening in the church in Corinth. Paul found out that the people were picking favorites. Favorites are often chosen for many reasons. The funniest, the most profound, the one who tells the most gripping or unusual stories, the one who touches the emotions. Paul dismisses them all, and he couched it in terms of the kingdom. Speakers, he says, are not the issue. The kingdom is the issue. Paul says, "For the kingdom of God is not just a lot of talk. It is living by God's power." In other words, being in the kingdom is not about picking favorite speakers who can make us laugh or who can manipulate our emotions. It is about life change. It is about holiness. It is about God's sovereign reign over our lives. Not religious activity, real power. If a person comes to a worship service and raises their hands and shouts hallelujah and serves in four different ministries and gives 20% of their income to the church and another 10% to the poor and can quote entire passages of scripture by heart, but they never change, are never transformed to be more like Jesus, they are living outside the kingdom. Outside. The kingdom is not about putting on a good show like a lot of pastor types can sometimes do. It is about wrecking the old value structures and replacing them with something far more beautiful. This is done through repentance and trust as the Holy Spirit leads us and reshapes us. That is the kingdom. That is God's power. Repent and trust today, Breakfast Club. Let's pray. Our Father, help us never to substitute religious activity for being in the kingdom, living life in the kingdom. May your Spirit guide us, direct us, convict us, challenge us, lead us, reign over us, and empower us to continually mature as followers of Jesus by your power. Take charge of us. Lead us. Be king over us, we ask. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, we are halfway through the week already. Tomorrow, we are going to see all about putting our eggs in the wrong basket. Well, what's that about? find out tomorrow when you join us at Breakfast at Tracy's. We'll see you then. Take care, everyone.